Don't you question it, John MacArthur, when 9/11 occurs? Don't you question your faith?
No, I don't question my faith. No, I mean,
And the guys who took the plane into the building didn't question theirs either.
And they I don't like that association too well.
Wait a minute. They didn't give their ultimate gift?
No, because...
They did not give their life?
I understand that God allows death. That does not mean that I take the side of a perpetrator of murder and slaughter.
I'm not saying take the side. I'm saying is, did they have a belief?
Oh, sure.
Okay.
Sure. A misguided, a severely misguided one.
In our opinion, it was misguided, of course.
Right.
But why is the death tragedy if death is good?
Well,
why is tragic used in the word death?
I'll answer that very simply. Nobody died in those towers that wasn't going to die anyway. Death is a reality. And the message is, you don't know when you're going to die, and you better be ready. Jesus told this story. He said there were some people worshiping in the temple. The Pilate's soldiers came in, sliced them up. Their blood mingled with the sacrifices. It was Passover. They said to Jesus, were they worse than everybody else? Jesus said, you better repent, or you'll also die and perish. And they said a tower fell and killed 18 people in Siloam. Were they worse than everybody else because they were crushed? And Jesus said, you better repent or you'll likewise perish. Mm-hmm. The Bible says you die and after this the judgment and then heaven and hell. And you're not going into eternity as energy, you're going as a person.
Let's include some calls. Clovis, California, hello.
Hello.
Hi.
If Jesus is the only way to get into heaven, was heaven empty and devoid of souls before Jesus came to earth?
John?
Oh, that's a very good question, and the answer is absolutely not. We know way back in the book of Genesis, Enoch didn't die. He walked right into the presence of God, and the prophet Elijah went to heaven in a whirlwind, and David said that when he died, he would see God face to face, and Job said when he died, he'd see God face to face, and the prophet Daniel spoke about a resurrection unto life. There was clearly in the Old Testament an indication that they were going to go to heaven, but they went to heaven because God provides for those Old Testament saints the same way he does for people on this side of the life of Jesus, resurrection life for those who believe in him. Jesus paid the penalty for their sins, and his righteousness was applied to them, past and future. But Jesus Christ, nonetheless, was the one who bore their punishment, even though he hadn't yet come.
We're back with our panel. Lake City, Colorado. Hello.
Hey there, Larry.
Hi.
Many of your guests have said that after we die, we either go to heaven or hell, and that's on the basis of whether we have faith in Jesus Christ or if we've done enough good deeds. And my question is what about the baby, the infant, who has not been able to come to an understanding of Jesus or not lived enough to do the good deeds to merit heaven?
Well, John, someone who doesn't even know about Jesus, an aborigine.
Yeah, I've written a book which has been widely received, and I'm very encouraged by it, by nursing associations and hospitals. It's called Safe in the Arms of God. And it takes an Old Testament, New Testament look at what happens to babies that die. And as I told you when we met the first time after 9/11, and you said, what happened to that baby at the bottom of that tower? And I said, instant heaven. And I said that in just that fast order because I had just prepared that book, and I think the weight of Scripture is very clear that infants that die or people who are mentally unable to make decisions and to operate in faith toward God, God gathers to himself, and I think Scripture is clear on that.
Do all of you agree on that, Father Matthew?
I think it's really important. I agree, certainly. But I think there's an important thing as a Christian for me to understand in my understanding of Jesus, that although I believe Jesus is the Son of God and he is the source of salvation of all, I believe that he can be able to be expressed in ways far beyond what I can understand. And so for me to condemn a person who loves the Father, a Jew or a Muslim that loves the Father, and say, well, Jesus is not
happy. How do you view Jesus, Rabbi?
I would say that Jesus was a great teacher. I do not believe he was divine. I do not believe he was the Son of God. And I might add, if Moses would claim to be that he's the Son of God, I would reject that as well.
What does Dr. Hathout believe?
I think our stand is almost identical to the rabbi. However, we believe that Jesus Christ is very special in a way because he is born to the Virgin Mary.
So, and you believe she was a virgin?
Oh, yes.
The Muslims believe?
Muslims believe there is a whole chapter in the Quran called Mary to highlight that. So we believe that he is described as the Word of God and a spirit from him to the Virgin Mary.
Marianne,
but we don't believe that he is the Son of God.
Marianne, what do you believe?
I believe that we are all the sons of God. And I believe that Jesus was and is a fully actualized, he was a fully actualized human being who now has the function of helping others who choose, who feel that he is their way, to help them rise as well. But I was so glad to hear the Father say that he acknowledges as a Christian that there are those who experience that vortex, as it were, without the name Jesus on it. And I find it very unfortunate and slightly offensive, this notion that if someone does not proclaim the name Jesus, you're talking about Jews, you're talking about atheists, you're talking about agnostics, Hindus, Muslims, Buddhists, who somehow, even if they aren't babies, if they do not proclaim the name Jesus, to me that is an incorrect understanding of Jesus himself.
And I appreciate what she's saying. The bottom line is that this is an authority issue. The Bible says, neither is there salvation in any other name than the name of Jesus Christ.
Why do you believe that's the only word?
Because I believe the Bible is true.
So he believes the Quran was true.
Well, I understand that, but I believe the Bible is true. I believe the Bible stands up scientifically, historically, prophetically. I believe every test to the Scripture yields its truth.
There's no hypocrisy.
But you know, Larry,
there are hypocrites described in the Bible, but the Bible
is true. Well, I meant to hold it. We've got to take a break. Ellen, what do you believe about Jesus Christ?
Well, I'm here to give the reality point of view, I guess, because the reality is that there is not one shred of secular evidence that there was ever a Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ and Christianity is a modern religion, and Jesus Christ is a compilation from a lot of other gods, Horus, Mithra, who had the same origins, the same death as the mythological Jesus Christ.
So you don't believe there was a Jesus Christ?
There was none. It's not what I believe, that there is no secular evidence that J.C., Jesus Christ, ever existed.